Okay, so what is a chakra? I remember when I was first going down the spiritual path, and you say that lightly. I've always been on the spiritual path. I've always been curious. I was a psychology major in college, and why did I do that? Because I was on the spiritual path. I was trying to figure out why. Why does this happen? Why does this work? You know, what does this all mean? And I remember it was 2008-ish, and I was getting my Reiki certifications, and I was kind of learning more about that. And I remember thinking, what the heck is a chakra? That's where this whole chakra embodiment idea comes from, because as a kinesthetic learner, as a visual learner, I had to do, I had to see, I had to feel. I couldn't just read a book and have someone tell me what the seven different chakras were. I needed to understand it. So, in general, chakra means wheel in Sanskrit, and they're known as energetic wheels within your body. Now, the one thing that gets kind of confusing as you learn and study more about this is that there are hundreds of chakras, at least 114 that I know of. There are different meridians and nadis within your body, and there are chakras connected to your different organs, and there are chakras in your palms of your hands and the soles of your feet and the back of your knees, and you know, all over the place. And they're all connected to the antenna of how our body functions. So in general, though, the seven main chakras are what we are going to be learning about and talking about in the chakra embodiment. And they are along the chakra column. And that basically is from the base of the spine all the way up to the top of the head. Now, in different traditions and different philosophies, there are left meridians, and there are right meridians, and there's that central meridian. So we're going to be focusing on that central meridian, that central energy flow right up the spinal column from the base of the spine all the way up to the top of the head. Now, if you're talking to different teachers, there are other chakras. There is the earth star chakra, for example, which is usually considered one or zero, depending on how you want to label it, which is the absolute connection to the earth. And then after you go up past the crown, there are other chakras. There's the soul star chakra and the spirit chakra and the galactic chakra and the divine gateway chakra. So there are different chakras that are connecting us to our divine life and path. But in general, it's considered to be a wheel of energy within our body that is connected to and relates to different organs and in our body and the physiological and psychological needs that our body has for this lifetime. So the bottom chakras are more about survival, and then the upper chakras are more about spirit, like connecting to your divine nature. So our goal in this lifetime is to be flesh and spirit in one, which is what the ascended master, Christ, Buddha, that's what these ascended masters accomplished, being flesh and spirit as one. So, what is a chakra? I have to tell you that when I started really studying this, the first big aha moment that I had, and there were many, was all my psychology training started coming back into play. This is knowledge that we have in our Western world. It might be a little bit behind, though, because the chakra and the chakra columns and the traditions, these are 5,000 plus years old. So we're kind of just slowly figuring this out. But for those of you that are new to this, or for those of you that aren't comfortable with chakras being, you know, spiritual or energetic, you can also look at them from the Maziel, sorry, what's his name, Marlowe's hierarchy of needs. So in Marlowe's hierarchy of needs, it's basically the same thing. It starts off with, I've got my little notes here. It starts off with psychological needs: air, water, food, shelter, sleep, clothing. And likewise, there is the root chakra, which is about survival, safety. It's about having the four walls, like you need to survive in this world. So what do you need? You need to breathe. You need to eat. You need to sleep. You need to have clothing. You need to have shelter. That's the most important stuff. You can't do anything else if you don't have those basic survival skills met. Then once you move up, the next section is safety and needs. So for Marlowe's hierarchy, he's talking about emotional security. He's talking about financial freedom. He's talking about law and order. He's talking about, you know, freedom versus fear. And the sacral chakra is almost exactly parallel to that. The sacral chakra is basically in the area right near your belly button. And it is the area that is connected to creativity and passion and joy. It's connected to feelings. So safety and needs. I need to feel safe, right? You need to be safe and then you need to feel safe. Those are the two most important needs that we have as human. So then there is the idea then of the solar plexus, which is the I am center. This is the chakra that connects how we present to the world, our willpower, our confidence. It's how we present, right? It's how we feel. I am. And just the same way with Marlowe's, we have this next one is love and belonging. So, right, we have belonging. The social needs need to be met. Social needs mean you need to be able to have interpersonal relationships. You need to feel like you're part of a group. You need to feel like there's belonging. You need to know who you are. Like, who am I? What am I going to do? And then the next chakra is the heart chakra. There's the love coming in. Same thing as Marlowe, right? Same thing. So the heart chakra is about love, loving yourself, unconditional love. It's about putting that energy out there. Then you move up first. And then the next is esteem in the Marlowe's hierarchy, right? Esteem is about self-worth. It's about accomplishment. And then the throat chakra, it's about speaking your truth. It's about being able to know, what to say and how to feel and how to be in this world. Then you go up again. And the last, world for Marlowe, the peak of his triangle is basically self-actualization. Well, there we have the third eye and the crown chakra. This is enlightenment. This is peak experiences. This is being able to understand your way in the world, to have knowing, to have intuition. So what is chakra? Chakra is an ancient energetic system that teaches us about the hierarchy of needs, just like Marlowe, Erickson. Also, I study, teaching. So early childhood education, you've got Steiner, you've got Erickson. These are all connecting. They're all fitting in with Erickson. We have trust versus mistrust. That is the root chakra, right? Who can I trust to survive? Then you've got autonomy versus shame. There's so much, like, who am I? What are my feelings? Do I feel good about this? Do I feel bad about this? Sacral chakra. Then we've got initiative versus guilt. That initiative, like, yeah, I'm going to get this done. I've got willpower. I've got confidence, solar plexus. And it goes up and up and up. And they almost parallel, they almost match all the way. So for those of you that are just learning, trying to figure out what is a chakra, people have all different analogies for it. I've heard, it's like a car, and a car needs to run, right? And if one piece isn't running right, then the lights are going to start to go on, and then other things are going to start to fail until all of a sudden the gas just isn't moving through and your car is dead on the side of the road. So you can keep pushing and pushing and pushing a car with a service engine light on, and it will keep going and going and going and going and going for a while. It'll keep pushing, and eventually it just dies. And so that's kind of our physical body too, right? Like pushing, that's where dis-ease comes from. That's where the idea that there's imbalance somewhere. So the imbalance comes from trauma or feelings or things that are pushed down that are creating blocks within your energetic center between your nadis, your meridians. So the energy is not flowing properly. Another analogy that I love actually is the inside of a clock. and you see all those different like gears and wheels that kind of connect into each other, and it's all complex. And if one pops out, then they can't work because they're all connected. They, you know, for this gear down here to work, this one has to be turning. So they're all flowing. Those energetic centers are flowing, and they're sending information back and forth through that central meridian that goes right down the central, the chakra column. So a chakra is a wheel of energy that's in our body. As I started learning more about the chakras, which we are going to be doing in this program, you're going to be able to start to understand how to embody them. Like, what does the root chakra mean when it's balanced versus imbalanced? What organs is it connected to? So if you're having, like, you know, ankle problems, you're like, wow, that's connected to the foundation, something to do with my root chakra. Where am I not feeling safe? Right? You start to learn these clues so you can start to figure out how to heal yourself, how to understand the signals that your body's giving, like the check engine light's on if your ankle's hurting all of a sudden. So what does that check engine light mean? Why is my ankle hurting? What does this mean? And you start kind of figuring out where the energetic center is so you can get that block out, so you can get that energy kind of flowing back up. That's what a chakra is. A chakra is a connection to your physical body. It's an energetic connection to your physical body that will give you clues and tips on how to live your best life, how to be in harmony, how to be in grace, and how to have the energy flowing freely from the base, your foundation, all the way up to your crown, the top of your head. It's a lot of information. There's lots of information. But the main thing is just to understand that it's just energy. A chakra is just energy that's flowing, that's moving through you. And if you have a block somewhere, it's going to cut off some of the energy. So you're not feeling that full flush of life force that's moving through you. So you want to feel that life force coming back through you. You want to feel more energized. You want to feel more healthy. You want to get your body back up and running. You want to put that check engine light off, right? You need to service your body. You need to heal your body. And your body is basically a roadmap to your energetic centers. If something's wrong in your body, then your body's giving you like a little map, like, hey, there's something we need to work on. Let's look at this shadow that's here. Let's look at the feelings that are here. How can we clean that gear off so that way that energy starts flowing again? So in this program, the Chakra Embodiment Program, you're going to be learning more and more about the 7 main chakras, and you're going to be learning about how to connect to them, how to embody them, how to relate to them, and how to understand them. So when your check engine light goes on in your body, you know where to go. You know what to do. All right. Thanks so much. I hope you have a wonderful, blessed day and a wonderful experience with the Chakra Embodiment Program. Reach out to me if you have any questions, facebook.com/loveandlight, spelled LUVNL888. You can find me on Instagram there as well. You can also find me on YouTube. So Love and Light, LUVNL888. It's my hashtag. All right. Thanks so much. Bye.